Hey everyone, it's Nina aka Sakafu. Today I'm showing you how I make my homemade cauliflower kimchi rice. And today I'm using my Korean restaurant Kimchi. They are a local family-owned business in La Palma that has amazing food and sides like this kimchi, so make sure to check them out in the link below. So see, these are some of the ingredients, and you need cauliflower, scallions, and onions. And some of the peppers you need are like cayenne pepper, chili powder, and ground oregano. You also need some olive oil, and this is how you cut an onion. You only need half of it, but you make sure to cut them and dice them. So it's kind of a weird process because I don't really know how to cut, but the same thing with the scallions, you need to dice them. So take off the roots, and if you're really creative, you can use these roots and put them in water. And so you can even grow your scallions, which I have here, and I've been growing so much scallions, to be honest, and it's just a really cool process to see. So you just need to cut those and dice them up. You really just need a few strands of those scallions to use, and you can really adjust how much that you really need. I just kind of cut however much I have. You also need to dice your cauliflower, and honestly, this is a huge head of cauliflower, and I'm still trying to learn how to cut this thing because sometimes it really flakes, so just be prepared with that. But you just really need small chunks, and you need to heat your flame to a medium-high, and then start putting oil onto the pan so that it can heat up. And just kind of drizzle that over your pan and make sure that your whole pan is coated on the bottom because you're gonna start frying the onions and scallions. And with these, you can adjust how much onions and scallions that you really want. I just think that the onions are really flavorful, so I just heat more of those and I literally switch them around in my pan. And something that I like to do is try to put them on the edges because I'm gonna be cooking them for longer, but also I'm gonna be putting them in a circle because I know that the middle of the pan is usually the hottest, so the next time I put ingredients, I know that's the one that's cooking first. So the next thing I put is cauliflower, obviously, and then I'm just gonna be mixing that around. And I really like to steam my vegetables just because it makes it softer and easier to eat, because it's nice to have crunchy vegetables, but then also you have the kimchi, so you want the flavor to absorb. The next thing I have is the kimchi, and I didn't show it, but you need to cut the kimchi beforehand, and it's probably easier to just cut the kimchi separately in a bowl and then put it in. And then afterwards, you start putting all your peppers in, and to be honest, I really just eyeball it. I start putting the cayenne pepper, the chili powder, the oregano, and if you want, red powder too. And then I just start drizzling that all together, just depending on my spice tolerance that day. And the next thing I put is the seaweed, and I start ripping that apart into like little chunks, because the end result is you're gonna be scrunching this seaweed on top of the pot. And I guarantee you, this is gonna be the most flavorful part of the cauliflower rice. It's so delicious, and you're gonna be craving it for each bite for the seaweed. It goes so well with the kimchi. So this is the final result with the kimchi cauliflower fried rice that I've been making. It's my favorite thing that I've been making so far in quarantine. It's really healthy, and it's actually low calorie, so bless on that, because we want to be leaving satisfied, right? So this is a great way for you to create a healthy substitute, but also adding some spice in your life. I guarantee you will enjoy this. You can even have this as a meal prep. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I want to give a big thank you to my Korean restaurant in La Palma, California. Don't forget to check them out, guys, because they have really, really good takeout. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. Babush!